Okay, here we are in the post-game program here, UCLA Sports Scene, and a very beautiful Sunday afternoon here. We're still in the, what we call winter, but looking like spring more and more each day, but we are now in softball season. And speaking with us now after a big win here, closing out the Southern California Collegiate Tournament here at UCLA Easton Field, head coach Kelly Inouye-Perez. Coach, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. You know, this opening weekend is always a lot of fun. Kind of get out there, and for us, we learn a lot about our team and where we are, and we got to walk away with a lot of positives. You know, it's early, so we always have things that we're going to work on, but a lot of great things happened this weekend.
And your goals are set very high from day one, 52 wins last year, and just on an average season for coaches to win that many games. Wow, that's a huge goal, Coach, and I'm sure you're going to be zeroing in on that and looking at that as well.
Well, you know, absolutely. I think winning is a big part of it, you know, to be able to gain those successes and see girls come through. For us, our focus this year is really about learning as much as we can so that we can be our best at the end. We had a very successful season last year, and a season that ended too soon, so this team is really focused on how we can be our best. Literally, I'm moving things around. We have different people and different opportunities. This team is very talented, and I'm excited about what's to come.
Very deep, not only with players, but with your coaching staff, Lisa Fernandez. Oh, my goodness, and on. So many of the UCLA alumni who stay in the sport and stay in academics and coaching, as yourself, we want to commend you for 22 years of Bruin, 9 years as head coach. And, Coach, you have seen a lot of young players, and our main interest today and for the rest of the season in her career is Jelly Felix. Great story in our community, and we'd just like to know the recruiting process. How did Jelly really get your attention, because you've seen so many good players?
Well, you know, I'm real fortunate. My recruiting coordinator is, you know, is Lisa Fernandez, and she knows the game. You know, three-time Olympian, gold medalist. Literally, she is the icon in our sport. So she goes out, and she'll look for the best talent, not just here in the California area, but all over the country, and we've even gone internationally. And Jelly Felix is somebody that literally she got a beat on, got a chance to see her, and had just great just great things to say. Her coaching staff, the team, the program she was on, knew one thing: she was going to fight. She's a fighter. And she's come in, and as a freshman in a very talented class, has earned her position, has come up, been able to give her the bat in some big situations, and she has just been clutch. She can come into big situations, and she's here, and she's literally left her mark as being one of the best pinch hitters off the bench, to the point where she could also get out in the field and be a starter. So we couldn't be more thrilled. Lisa Fernandez literally brought her in the program, and she's working it, getting after it every day.
Well, kudos to you, of course, having the final affirmation on the recruits, and then speaking, of course, very closely with your coaches, because in this level here of Division I play, there's so many facets that the public doesn't see. And you're 24/7 almost in terms of your coaching season. You're always working, Coach.
Well, absolutely. You know, I think the key to the success, I love my job because I'm surrounded by people that are just as passionate and as committed as I am. We're here not just to win championship games, but we are developing individuals to be leaders beyond just this sport. So, you know, our philosophy is very simple. Family, the people that we surround ourselves with are important. School, the degree. So that's a big opportunity, is to get that opportunity, to get that degree. And softball is what we all love to do. And yeah, we're on a mission.
Yes. And we bring it back to Jelly Felix, because we're very proud of her, of course, not only in East LA, but, and I say beyond as well, because Lincoln is a Northern League, Wilson school, there's Torres, there's Garfield, there's Roosevelt. So many schools that we see our young student athletes in high school who like to pursue a very, very strong career at D1 level, and Jelly is going to be, as they would say, our role model and inspiration for a lot of young ladies.
Well, I think Jelly provides a great story, you know, that it is possible, that you can put the hard work in, and she does a great job of that. She has worked very hard, and she's had great support from her family to be able to get to this point, but she is a reality. It can happen. You know, for all of us, we come from different places, but we all come together, and we get this wonderful opportunity, and Jelly Felix should be an inspiration. She should be an inspiration that anything is possible if you put hard work, got support from your family, and anything, your dreams can come true. And Jelly's a living dream.
And there's a bright future for her, not only for this year, she'll be coming back for another 2 more years at least to be part, an integral part of the Bruins. I want to say Lady Bruins, but it's the Bruins softball team.
Yeah, well, we're excited. I think, you know, for her to be able to come in, and she's had some great moments already early in her career, and that doesn't happen all the time, especially in a program like this. You work your way in. But she's done a great job, and the future's exciting.
And as they say on the internet and social media, she's blowing up. You know, in this tournament here, a grand slam.
Let's
go go back to the first Idaho State, was it, the first game?
Yes. Well, you know, I think the game is the game, and there's always going to present opportunities. But, you know, for her to be able to come in she was a little injured in the fall, so she didn't get to work as hard.
Yeah.
But to come into the game in her first at bat and literally hit a grand slam, I mean, she just picked up where she was last year as far as just being clutch. She knows how to hit, and it's a lot of fun. So I have great confidence being able to go to her at any time. Believe she's always prepared. Mm-hmm. And, like, literally, that was a big blow. Oh, and sent the crowd, you know, the crowd was screaming with excitement as that walk-off was a big one.
And we will follow her, as we mentioned, Coach, for the rest of the season and beyond. So our work is just getting started here with you. We hope to create a good relationship with you as well.
I love that. We're real proud of her. We're really proud of her family and the fact that she's here. Like I say, she's a real living dream of anything is possible. If you put your mind to it, literally, it can become your reality.
Champions are made here.
Champions are made here. That's right. Thanks for coming.
Coach Kelly Inouye-Perez, thank you so much. Absolutely. And good luck in the tournaments that are coming up.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Take care.
All right. We're going to come back with Jelly Felix in just a moment. Angelica Jelly Felix, she's up next for East LA Sports Teams postgame as the Bruins defeat the San Diego State Aztecs 4-1 here at Easton Field, UCLA campus. We'll be right back. And here we are with Jelly Felix. First name, Angelica Jelly is the nickname, Felix. But we want to welcome you to East LA Sports Scene. And Jelly, how are you doing after a nice win today?
I'm doing great. You know, I'm doing fantastic. A win's a win. So everything's great.
And the buzz is just really reverberating in East LA, and I say and beyond, because our charge and our mission is to follow our athletes, especially Latin American, Latina athletes or Latino. It doesn't matter. Wherever they go, we've always made a commitment to follow them and get the story told even further in many ways from our perspective. And that's why we ask you to come on and talk to us. But you're also talking, as you know, to the mijas as well, and the jellies that are younger than you.
Yeah.
But here you are, UCLA, first tournament, first games of the season, and your first at bat. We just talked to Coach Inouye-Perez, and she says, walk off, walk up, Jelly, and do it for us. And you, of course, won the game with a huge hit. But talk about that moment here, because it's very, very important.
At that moment, I didn't really think, oh, hit a home run or do whatever. In that moment, I just said, you know what, just hit something hard. I've always been told, just hit something hard, and something good's going to happen. But once I hit that ball, I knew that thing was out, and I was just, I'm not the type where I like to show my emotion out on the field, unless it's a championship game.
Yes.
But I knew, I was like inside, okay. But other than that, like, it's just, I don't really make too much commotion about it, because it's what's expected of me, especially as a D1 athlete. Yes. It's typical, it's what's expected.
Jelly, let's just go back for a moment or two, because the roots, the Lincoln High School, the Tigers, your days spent as a young lady, young student athlete, thinking about your future and where you wanted to play at college. Tell us about how your experience at Lincoln prepared you for the recruitment to come to UCLA.
Lincoln, the whole thing about going to Lincoln High School, it just helped me, you know, the whole diversity thing and the whole mental toughness thing, because over there you're competing with other students and everything like that, with especially where Lincoln High School was located. It helped me, you know, have thick skin, everything like that, and helped me come. When I came over here, it helped me where, you know, everything wasn't too bad. It was easy, not anything hard.
Okay. And then a little bit about your playing skills, your fundamentals. Where did you really gather those together, and who taught you? Was it family? Somebody in the family that really pointed you to baseball?
Everything that I do, the hitting, running, fielding, throwing, is from my father. My father has been there for me since day one, since I was literally two. He had me playing softball, but
yes.
I'm very grateful that I have someone like that that was able to push me. And you know, those times where I was just like, I don't want to do it anymore, and he's like, no, your butt's gonna get out there and you're gonna do it. And you know what, thinking back now, I just really I'm really thankful that he did that for me, or else I wouldn't be here right now.
As they say, the major influencers in our lives, and those of us that are fortunate to have two parents, we always look back to mama and papa, and they're so special.
Definitely.
Any brothers or sisters also?
I have two younger brothers, Arturo Felix and Antonio Felix. Arturo Felix is actually a freshman at Bishop Amat High School, so he's up there doing his thing, and hopefully he's going to be a Bruin here one day too. or USC, whatever one. I guess I'll live with USC. And the little one actually plays, Antonio actually plays baseball too, so we'll see. And I have an older brother too. Mm-hmm. He played baseball and football, but he's over there living his life right now.
Okay, and as we speak about you and your profile, because it's not just about, as they say, fielding, hitting, running, bases and all that, the academics was also an attraction to come to UCLA for, of course, your degree.
Academics was the biggest thing. Academics is, just let alone to have a UCLA degree and to be able to go into a job and just say, wow, like, she was able to juggle softball and school and with the high education program that they have over here, it's just phenomenal. And then with everything else, like the networking, you meet new people, and just the whole family aspect of UCLA, you're just... You'll be friends with everyone, these girls, all the other athletes for life, and they're just amazing.
And those that are coming in your footsteps, because when Coach Inouye-Perez told us about the recruiting process, it was the Hall of Famer herself, Lisa Fernandez, that made a lot of the conversation and dialogue and at the invitation to come and take a look at UCLA. Tell us about how that experience went.
Yeah, it was actually when I first got the look... I was young. I didn't write any letters. I was 14. I did not write any letters to any college. I didn't think about it until I got a letter saying, or, you know, UCLA's interested in you. And I was like, what? Like, are you serious? Like, come on, I'm 14 years old. Like, are you serious? Then going along the lines, I played and I went to go fielding with George Arahu. He coaches at Fullerton now. At that time, he was coaching the Firecrackers. Okay. And he knew Coach I and Lisa, and he was just like, you know, UCLA, UCLA, UCLA. And I was like, really, George? Like, do you think I could play that? And he looked at me like, dude, you could play that. You just got to put, you know, all your time and effort, and you got to really work hard for it. And that's what I did. And with the help of my dad and everything else and my other, you know, family members, I was able to do it. And
si se puede. I want to make sure your mom, because we're going to speak to her too. We're going to speak to both your parents. But the influencing of mom, how strong was that in terms of a magnet to keep you attracted to UCLA?
Yeah, my mom was also my second biggest, you know, supporter. She pushed me a lot too. There was times where I came home from school and I was like, I'm too tired from softball. I don't think I'll be able to do my homework. And she would literally slap the homework on the table and say, no, your butt's going to end up doing it whether you like it or not. If you want to get into UCLA, you better do it. So she was also the other rock on my support system.
And lastly, before we let you go, Jelly, because I know you're going to get with the team, and then there's a post-game things that you have to do, and then, of course, there's studies.
Yeah, definitely
studies. But I wanted to ask you the terms of your educational degree, what your major may be, or you undecided at this point?
Right now, I'm deciding to be a sociology major, but after I graduate, I'm going to come back and major in biology. What I want to do, I want to be a biochemist major, everything like that. Because with softball and everything like that, it's hard to be able to juggle, you know, the life science courses and the labs and stuff when we're traveling. We're going here and there, here and there. Yeah. So, you know, just major in social right now and then come back and major in biology,
Last request, a comment for our viewers who are just so proud when we posted the fact that we were coming to watch you, and then a couple of your grand slam, our viewers started to really respond and saying, go, Jelly, go, go. But there's going to be more viewers, and you're just basically your message to them as to how you will be conducting yourself for the next couple of years here at UCLA and what you're going to be doing in terms of playing and getting that degree.
Well, I just want to say one thing to everyone out there that's watching this. Just work hard. I know it's when times get rough, just push through it, and you're going to do it because anyone could do it. If I could do it, you could do it. And I'm 5'2", and I'm playing with these girls that are 6'3". And I'm over here doing my thing, banging and taking advantage of all the chances that I have. So just work hard and keep chipping away. That's all I have to say. Just keep chipping away.
There it is. We're going to keep chipping away watching Jelly Felix with a successful, highly successful career here at UCLA. Thank you, Jelly, and good luck in the tournaments coming up and then for the Pac-12 and beyond. So our mission, we will follow. Thank you very much. Okay, we're going to break off now and then go up top now to meet the Felix family. Mom and Dad are here, and then we're going to wrap things up here. From UCLA's Easton Field, the Lady Bruins, or the Bruins, winning 4-1 over the San Diego State Aztecs. We'll be back in a moment. Okay, and rounding out our special coverage of Jelly Felix, a UCLA Bruin, and she's a utility player for this team here, and she's going to be doing much, much more as her career expands at UCLA. But after this game today, a big win over the San Diego State Aztecs in a tournament that just kicked off the season, we are now able to speak with the proud parents of Jelly Felix. And first of all, I want to introduce Arturo.
Hi, nice to meet you.
And Frances.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Okay, and we want to obviously speak to you about the pride level you're feeling, the inspiration that your daughter is now providing to many, many mijas and the young ladies out there, and men and others. Both genders really love a great story. But, Dad, how do you feel now about being here watching your daughter play for UCLA?
Well, I'm very proud of her. Words can't, describe. Anytime she, just to suit up, just to be a Bruin, I keep telling her, fight the fight, win the fight, battle. She loves all the girls on the team. She loves the team, loves the school. She's proud to be here. She's very much well aware that she's opened doors, and mm-hmm. she's a great role model in the neighborhood, and she continues to do it here, academically and mm-hmm. and as an athlete, academics first. I've always pushed, coaching at Lincoln High School mm-hmm. With Mark Shapiro, we would always talk about how important academics are before mm-hmm. anything, mm-hmm. Absolutely. And. She does the best she can, she tries to fill every role. She doesn't ask for too much. She does whatever they ask of her. And that's why I'm most proudest of her there. Yes. She's going to do whatever she can.
And Frances, you have to be feeling even more abundant in terms of that pride, because she's a young lady. And many of our ladies, of course, in East L.A. and beyond, Northeast L.A., wherever our kids are, this opportunity is sometimes not even in the grasp of many, many young ladies. But now, hopefully, because the buzz is out there, the word is out, and better know who Jelly Felix is when her name comes up, you have to really be very, very proud of her.
Yeah, I'm very, very proud. I mean, words can't even describe what she went through just to get here, mom doing the mom duties, and dad, as a trainer, helping her get here, and I'm doing the financial aid, whatever she can to get here. And just, like she told me, she says, Mom, coming to UCLA, you think we could do it? I said, yes, we can. Mm-hmm. Me, your dad, your brothers, it's a family. It's a family support, and that's what we're supposed to do. And the community, all my friends, all people that I don't know, just coming up and talk to her and ask about her. And I'm like, she's here for us. She's here for the community. She, for family, for her team, for school, and for the community. And she says, I want to make everybody proud,
And I'm sure in our culture, we have always taught that where there's a will, there's a way. At least many of us always felt that from our parents. And yours truly speaking, where there's a will, there's a way. And many times, Jelly told us at least a couple of times where it was getting very, very hard. She'd come home, didn't want to do the homework or didn't feel like doing the homework. But, hey, Mom and Dad mm-hmm. kept pushing her, kept inspiring her to go forward.
Oh yeah, she had her ups and downs. Of course, just like everybody else, whether it be complacency, she was either lazy, just like everybody else, and push. And she would look at me like I was some kind of slave driver. But I said, hey, what? You have to get that thick skin. You have to work hard. I don't ever want you to sit back and say I deserve. Mm-hmm. I tell all the girls that I don't want to hear I deserve. I want you to earn it. Yes. I want you to earn it. No deserves here. I don't care where you come from. You go out there and earn it. You can do it. I don't want to hear it because they live there or because mm-hmm. they have this, because they have mm-hmm. that. I've heard that too long. Yeah. See, you go out there and earn it. It's there for you. Go get it. No one's going to give it to you. And that's exactly what she did.
And Frances, you got to be also talking about, or at least knowing, in the Felix family, another extended family where there's more pride even bubbling and surfacing and talking about Jelly's accomplishments. Talk about how the family now is getting behind all of the movement here for Jelly to support her.
I mean, they're just, 100%, her two younger brothers, Arturo, who is attending Bishop Amat, and he's playing baseball there, and he looks up to his sister, and even Antonio, our 10-year-old, he just, wow, looking at my sisters, they're so proud of her, and it's hard, because my son is playing baseball as well, so we're going back and forth. Yeah. So family, you know, my really good friends, my family, his family, you know, the community is just, you know, rallying for Jelly. Yeah. You know, it's funny because, you know, like, we're, you know, I'll put, hey, her good moments that she has here and her not so good moments. And they're like, no, it doesn't matter. She still said, no, hey, we got to tell them the truth, you know, because, you know, don't, like she says, Mom, I'm not going to use an excuse where I come from that I can't do it. She says, no. She goes, I'm going to do it with the help of my family.
And Dad, Arturo, here we are, 2015, the first tournament of the season, and lo and behold, game one, pinch hitting now for the UCLA Bruins, Jelly Felix, and lo and behold, she snapped out and popped out a Grand Slam home run. Your thoughts on that at-bat and what you were thinking and what you were trying to transmit to her mentally.
Well, usually when I tell her, I said, hey, look, at whether they have you bunt, whether they have you take, a walk is as good as a home run. A walk is as good as any hit. If you could get on any way you can, you know, just do what you got to do. Team play is number one. She looked at some good pitches. She picked one out, did the best she could, and it happened to go out. I'm looking for something hard on the ground. That's her role, mm-hmm. is to move runners.
Yes.
And hey, you know, if we, as we call it in hitting, if it missed and it went, I'm proud of her. It happened, you know. And do we look for it all the time? I tell her, don't look for that all the time. Yeah. Yeah. Just if you strike out, pop up, whatever. If we come up short, don't despair. You're a Bruin. Right. You're a Bruin, right. And I'm proud of her. I'm proud of her. Just handle yourself like a champion. Don't. Okay. I mean, there's plenty of young eyes looking. Mm-hmm. You know, we need positive role models. I just said, you know, just keep a smile on your face, keep that pep in your step, and yep. And you're good. Very proud of her on that.
And we've got to really compliment UCLA, although it's very infrequent. We still compliment them anytime we see one of our own student athletes from the Vadio, from Southgate, mm-hmm. from Roosevelt, from Garfield, from Lincoln, because we have not seen a Mexican-American or Latino-American player here since Lorenzo Mata played basketball on the, remember the division, the Final Four, three teams. So UCLA, now we're focusing on the student athletes, and whether they be male or female, we will follow. And you are now in that light, Frances, to know that your daughter will be very, very well followed.
Yes, I'm, you know, just proud, you know, that Grand Slam. I was shaking. I couldn't, you know, believe it. Not that she couldn't do it, just couldn't believe it. Oh, my God, her first at bat, wow, you know, and just, you know, just so proud of her, you know. And, you know, UCLA, you know, like she says, you know, Mom is team first, you know, and I'm going to do whatever I can for the team. And that's what she's doing.
And she will continue. Arturo, Frances, very proud parents. We share that emotion with you. We want to convey that to the many, many viewers that are just really blown up and very happy and very buzzed to see Jelly's playing here at UCLA. Last words to the Lincoln community, to other youngsters that are in sports, because this is a great vehicle.
Academics first. That's all I could say is academics first. Do your homework. Maintain a good relationship with all your teachers. Go to school. Respect your parents. It starts at home. They fund your program. Mm-hmm. If you don't respect your parents at home, you're not going to respect anything around you, you know. And just work hard. You know, everything earned, nothing deserved. Everything earned.
There it is. Francis, final word.
You know, the same thing that I say. You know, just go out there. You know, get yours. Do it. You know, sacrifices. You know, sacrifices. Whatever you do to sacrifice to get where you're going, it's well worth it. Trust me, we know.
And as we all say with our slogan, si se puede. And Jelly Felix, she will be in our, as they say, on our radar screen for the next several years as we follow here at UCLA and on to a great student athlete career here. And we will see you again very, very soon. Okay?
Go Brew.
Go Bruins.
All right. That's going to do it. And we're going to do our sign off now. I'm just going to go right underneath the sign here, Art, let me slip in there. And I'm going to say now, on behalf of Erik Sarni, yours truly, Rico Cabrera, thanks for watching this edition of UCLA Sports Scene as we brought you Jelly Felix in her second year at UCLA as a Bruin, and they win here in this season, first season tournament at UCLA's Easton Field. We'll be back, of course, to cover her as her career progresses. So that'll do it for this edition. Thanks for watching, and take care. We'll see you very soon on our next edition of East LA Sports Scene.
Run them. Run them like run them.